You broke the contract when you killed us in the streets and didn't give a fuck. People are like, well, what did you gain? Well, what did you get from looting? I think that as long as we're focusing on the what, we're not focusing on the why.
Yeah, I think looting is bad.
I don't care how you decide to organize and protest, but you don't f***ing riot. You don't burn s*** in my goddamn neighborhood.
Right now, what are y'all doing? Y'all doing nothing. Because that's not gonna bring my brother back at all.
Let's ask ourselves why in this country in 2020 the financial gap between poor blacks and the rest of the world is at such a distance that people feel like their only hope and only opportunity to get some of the things that we flaunt and flash in front of them all the time is to walk through a broken glass window and get it. That they are so hopeless that getting that necklace, getting that TV, getting that change, getting that bed, getting that phone, whatever it is that they're gonna get, is that in that moment when the riots happen and if they present an opportunity of looting, that's their only opportunity to get it. We need to be questioning that why. Why are people that poor?
It is blatantly wrong to create an excuse of out of discrimination and disparity to loot and burn our communities.
So when they say, why do you burn down the community? Why do you burn down your own neighborhood? It's not ours. We don't own anything. There's a social contract that we all have, that if you steal or if I steal, then the person who is the authority comes in and they fix the situation. But the person who fixes the situation is killing us. So the social contract is broken. And if the social contract is broken, why the fuck do I give a shit about burning the fucking Football Hall of Fame, about burning a fucking Target? You broke the contract when you killed us in the streets and didn't give a fuck. You broke the contract when for 400 years we played your game and built your wealth.